Hey poopsies, welcome back to another ASMR video. Here's some ASMR in my new kitchen. First video in this kitchen. I'm going to be making some soy wax candles, and I bought a soy wax candle kit from Amazon. I'll probably link it below for reference, but instructions, so I'm just gonna follow them literally for this. This makes four ounce tin container candles plus a bonus 6 cube melt tray for extra wax, so I might use that as well. This kit contains 1 pound of 415 soy container wax. My company Okuchunga used soy wax to make candles, so I'm very familiar with these. It's very flaky, soft and brittle. It's one of the most valuable waxes in candles and preferred. Takes quite a bit of time to melt as well. So, have to follow instruction on that. Next is a four ounce candle tin containers. Four of these. One color chip will be a random color that we provide. I think I got yellow or orange, I'm not sure, but I guess we'll see when the result comes out. It's probably yellow. Four cotton wicks. These are the wicks with the bottom portions for attaching to the tin. Sound of candle making. Something new and exciting for me to do for you poopsies. Okay. And there are four wick stickers. Oh, sorry. Wrong stickers. These are the stickers. I don't want to unpeel them now, but they're in between these two. Necessary. So we're sticking the wicks on the tin cans. Four candle warning labels. These are the ones. So they basically say Mel's Candles. That's the name of our company that sent this through Amazon. Warning. By the way, this is not sponsored. It's just my purchase, my opinion. Only burn in suitable container. Burn for no longer than 2 hours at a time. Keep away from flammable materials. Keep wick centered and trimmed to 1/4 of an inch. Keep away from drafts, children, and pets. Never leave a burning candle unattended. We all know that, but this is just her warning, so I guess she doesn't get sued if she causes a fire. Okay. And 2 1-ounce dropper bottles of fragrance oil, and the scents will vary, I guess, between purchases. These are summer oranges and cucumber melon. So very summery. spring kind of candle, perfect for the occasion. It's April. I just love these droppers. You can just pinch them like an udder. And I just love the clicking sounds. Don't have fun with that. Says you will also need a glass microwave safe container. I came prepared. This is microwave safe. It's by Pyrex.
Oh, my voice sounds like in Star Wars when I talk in this. Let's make some soy wax candles.
Stirring spoon. This should not melt with the wax. It should be good. It's by Salvalon. Okay. Fingernail clippers or scissors. I found it interesting that they said covered work surface, which I'm guilty to say I don't have right now. It's just a kitchen. A kitchen will get messy. You can always clean it up after, so no biggie. I guess they want to be precautious of the wax spilling, you know, hot wax and cooling or scraping. It's hard to wash. I spilled some on some carpet once. It was such a pain to get off. But someone from my vlog channel told me to put ice cubes on top. Fun making your own candles, it says. This kit provides you with all the major things you need to make your own beautiful fragrance candle. This is a fun way to bond with your kids and perfect for science fair projects. Well, I don't see any kids here, so I guess I'm a kid. Directions. Step 1. Prepare candle tins. Okay. Wipe each tin with a paper towel to remove any dust or instruction. Even if they don't have dirt, I'm still gonna do it. Okay, so let me get some paper towels. Hold on a second. I'm very by the book with these things. Hello, this also makes good sounds. Thank you. remove a wick stickum. What's a wick stickum? There needs to be pictures on this. Melscandals.com. There need to be a picture. From the paper sheet and place the stickum on the bottom of the pre-wicked tab. Pre-tabbed wick. What's a pre-tabbed wick? See, that's very unclear. If a kid does this, they would not really know what to do. Remove the second paper backing from the stickum on the wick tab and place the wick in the center of the 4-ounce tin. Okay, so thankfully I know what to do from experience. So we get... my hand is itchy. We get one of the stickums, okay? Stick them up. I'm just gonna walk away and put it on 10 minutes on blast on high, and I'm just gonna use the bathroom and be on my phone and Instagram. Melting wax typically takes 4 to 5 minutes, but can vary depending on microwave. Be careful not to overheat wax once it liquefies in container, and melted wax will be hot. Use caution when removing melted wax from microwave. The dye chip to the wax flakes in the container. Place the container of soy wax flakes in the microwave and heat the wax for 4 minutes. Okay. And after heating for 4 minutes, I carefully remove the plastic container of melted wax from the microwave and I stir. Caution, container and wax will be hot. If the wax is not completely melted, continue to heat at 30-second intervals until the wax liquefies. Note, the dye chip may not be completely dissolved. Don't worry, simply stir the melted wax until it dissolves. Place the plastic container of melted wax to the side on a level surface. Okay, let's get that done. Microwave safe glass container. And le soy wax. It should all fit in here. Pour. shape. So this part was too loud, I couldn't film it and keep cutting it off, but it's right there, as you can see, it's extremely hot, can't even touch it. The dye has completely melted and I have to keep stirring it so it doesn't harden, but it's a nice orange, gold, yellow, whatever color. Now for step three. Oh, it's actually hardening very fast, so I better hurry. I have to pour the wax into two separate containers, making sure to equally split the wax. There should be a little over 8 ounces in each container. Then simply adding fragrance oil. Some orange in one container and the other velvet berry in the other container. Please note, for lighter scented candles, do not add the entire. Actually, pour them into two separate tins, not containers. All right, scratch that. I put half of it in two tins, and the other half is going to stay in this glass bowl. Now, cucumber melon. I have no idea how to open this. There we go. It's a dropper, so I have to. Stir wax and allow it to cool. Okay, you could have said that earlier. Getting the spoon and quickly stirring, stirring, stirring. Oh, these fragrances smell nice. Okay. I'm stirring the other one now. Stir wax slowly for 2 minutes. This will ensure that the color and fragrance are thoroughly mixed in and will also help cool the wax for pouring. Try not to add air bubbles to the wax when stirring. Okay, so I'll keep stirring. Just keep stirring. Just keep stirring. Next is pour wax in candle tin. Carefully pour the melted wax into prepared tin to about 1/4 inch from the top of the tin. Place a bar, anything sturdy, across the center and let the wick rest up against it. This will keep the wick straight and centered while the candle is cooling. Okay. Step 6. Clean microwavable container. While plastic or still warm, wipe off any extra wax with a paper towel or rubbing alcohol to clean the container. Do not pour leftover wax down the sink. Leftover wax can be poured and stored in a labeled paper cup for future use. Mm-hmm. And step 7, allow candle tins to cool. Trim wick and add warning label. Allow candles to cool overnight. Trim wick to 1/4 inch. Place the candle tin lid on each container. Add warning label to the bottom of each tin and enjoy. Remember to wish there was like a fan or something you could use to blow cool them faster. There's no instruction on that, but while it is cooling, I'm gonna put the stickers on the bottom. I guess it's not wise to put it now because of the heat. But it'll be cold by then, so I can put them anyway. Thank you. from this bowl. In the freezer. It smells very light of a scent, so this will be great of use for me when I need extra. Okay. Some wax melts, which again hardened very nice. I can crack one open one by one like this and use the wax melts. Cube wax melt for your aromatherapy needs. Okay. And of course the two different scented tins of candles. Okay. And so these smell so good. And I'm gonna actually trim the wick now. Alright, so test. Okay. And light the other one. flame. So keep that in mind. Be careful of that. And you'll begin to smell the aroma. It's super lovely little project to do with kids. Thank you guys for joining me on this journey. Please be sure to subscribe, like this video, share it.